All right, speaking of Pittsburgh, I think there's only one place to go after that is the guy who grew up as Iceberg. I think he was one of the original Icebergs. Is our friend, the lovely, the talented Steve Mears. He's in Philadelphia, the city of champions, former home of the home of the Philadelphia Eagles, former Super Bowl champion. All right, let's get to it, Mearsy, because Coach Mike Sullivan called Evgeni Malkin's return probable for tonight. What can you tell us?
My guess is he's going to be in. He said probable. He took the line rushes. He has looked very good in numerous skates now with his teammates, with his line mates. I got to think he is going to be in here at the end of this three-game road trip. And the Penguins need him right now. They're struggling and lost four in a row. They could use his talent, his leadership. And, it's a shame that he got injured last week because he had just had a really solid game. Remember, I was on the show with you guys. I was talking about Malkin coming back from the bye week, and he would probably be the player to most benefit from the time off. He had been struggling. He's got one goal in the last 10 games. So I thought the rest could really do him some good. He comes back, plays a couple of games, one of them against the Tampa Bay Lightning, gets hit by Dan Girardi, and it was a real rough game against the Bolts. He ends up getting injured. Nothing serious, though, but he's missed the last five games, upper body injury. He was flying in the morning skate today, so I got to think he is going to be in, and looks like he's going to be reunited with Phil Kessel and one of the newcomers in Nick Bjugstad. That's an interesting second-line combination that I'm looking forward to seeing if that's the way that it goes. But the Penguins need some depth scoring, and they need their big names here tonight, having lost four in a row. But EJ, as you know, what else could snap them to attention other than a trip to Philadelphia and a game against the Flyers?
Yeah, no question about that. We're all looking forward to that one tonight. A big game when you look at the points and in the standings right now. And there's some more good news, Mearsy, for the Pens, as Matt Murray is starting in net tonight. What's the level of concern for Murray as he continues? He's just kind of getting dinged up all the time.
Yeah, we're not privy to the details of the injuries, so not really sure exactly what it was. We just know it was upper body. It wasn't serious. He really just missed one game. He backed up the last game in Tampa, and Casey DeSmith played in that one, a 5-4 loss against the Tampa Bay Lightning. So it's tough to, when you don't have the injury information, it's tough to know what's bad luck on some of these. What's an injury maybe that, if there's a change in preparation or something like that, he might be able to prevent it a little bit more. But yeah, it was a nagging upper body injury, nothing serious. He's back in there tonight. Remember when he came back from missing the month, he was outstanding. He won 10 of 11 starts. And lately, I think the entire team in front of him has struggled over his last three or four starts, so the stats haven't really been there. But he's the number one guy, there's no question about it. Number one goaltender for the Penguins. They need him back in there. And going up against Carter Hart, what a goaltending matchup, right? You've got Matt Murray, who tonight feels like a veteran, even though he's only 24 years of age, and going up against 20-year-old Carter Hart. Rivalry game. Murray has always played well against the Philadelphia Flyers. Of course, he was very good in the playoff series last year. So, that's big news for the Penguins to get those two names back. Murray, we know he's going to start, and it sure looks like Evgeni Malkin is going to be back after missing the last five.
I'm kind of surprised Jimmy Rutherford doesn't confide in you with these type of injury updates. I think he would lean on you.
I'm not at all.
For advice.
I'm not at all.
All right. Well, let's try again.
He has better things to do.
How about Justin Schultz now? Now, he's ruled out for tonight, so what's the latest there? When might we see Justin Schultz?
It's very close, EJ, very close for Justin Schultz. It was almost exactly 4 months ago he suffered a leg fracture in Montreal. And there's another player, the Penguins, they need him. He's a right shot defenseman, second power play option, a great puck mover. We know what he did in 2017 when Chris Letang was out and was basically the number one defenseman on the way to another Stanley Cup for the Pens. They've really missed him. And one of the more underrated players on this roster. So I think on Wednesday, it will be 4 months exactly since that injury took place. And that was the prognosis after the surgery. They said he was going to be out for 4 months. He has been skating and joining the practices, full contact, including earlier this morning. He was out there. I got to think he's extremely close, but he's missed a whole lot of time. And there's no way that you could be on the treadmill. You can go through all these morning skates and everything. He has said it. The only way is to get into games. And there will be some bumps along the way. He hasn't played in 4 months, but the Penguins need him. They've struggled with those zone exits. There have been some bad turnovers at inopportune times over these last four or five games or so. And having a right shot on the blue line, incredibly valuable. They're a little left-handed heavy among their defensemen, aside from Chris Letang, obviously. So, yeah, they really miss Justin Schultz. I don't think that gets talked about enough because he's a really underrated defenseman. And the power play has been a struggle lately. There'd be another option for you, but obviously he's not going to be playing tonight here in Philly.
All right, Mirzi, good to see you in Philly. I hope that your security detail is tight around you because I know how much they love you there in Philly.
That's okay. Thank you for profiling Iceberg, by the way. I want to throw in also three-time Stanley Cup champion mascot, Iceberg. And I love Mike Johnson with the Bowling Green education, noticing the play on words on Iceberg. Very smart, very smart. But thanks for having me.
Couldn't slip that by him. No way. All right, Mirzi, get to work. We'll see you soon.
Thanks a lot. Talk to you later.